Today, I'd like to talk about The Miz. The Miz has been in WWE for the best part of 20 years, and there's not really much that he has not accomplished. He is a two-time WWE champion, an eight-time Intercontinental champion, and is one of two superstars that can actually call themselves a two-time Grand Slam winner, the other one being Seth Rollins. But so far in 2023, The Miz has had 10 matches, and he's lost all 10 of them. So guys, in this video, I'm going to be talking about why The Miz deserves better. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel for another wrestling discussion video. Now, I've been thinking about what I've been calling these recently. I've done a few videos over the last few weeks on sort of wrestling topics and this, that, and the other. I did one on football as well the other day. Now, I'm thinking I'm going to be calling these Parker's Hot Topics in wrestling or in football or whatever. Welcome back to another Hot Topic video, this time talking about WWE and The Miz. I could have really worded that better, but yes, we're going to be talking about The Miz today. Now, like I've said in the intro and everything, Mike Mizanin has been in WWE for the best part of 20 years. I believe he debuted in either 2004 or 2005. If you count the whole Tough Enough thing, then he was in WWE before 2005. So we'll go with that. Now, originally in that sort of thing with Tough Enough, he came second to Daniel Puter. And yeah, that just didn't go well, did it? He was completely obliterated in the Rumble. And then we didn't see him again. So that was a bit of a waste. But yeah, Mike Mizanin, he's 42 years old. So in terms of like wrestling and everything, he's still in the age range where he could still be pushed into some sort of a big feud. Maybe not WWE Championship or World Heavyweight Championship, but certainly used better than what he's being used at the moment, because this is awful at the moment, and excuse the pun, but he deserves better than this. Like we said, he's 42 years old. He's nowhere near done, I don't think. He's a very first Grand Slam, two-time Grand Slam champion, won every single available title in WWE, excluding the Universal title, two times or more. He's won the United States Championship twice, I think, maybe even three. Multiple-time tag team champion, Intercontinental champion, only one reign behind Chris Jericho, the current record holder. The Miz has won Money in the Bank. He has cashed in Money in the Bank twice. Once, a first time against Randy Orton, second time against Drew McIntyre. Both times he won the title. Yes, when he won the title from Drew McIntyre, he lost it to Bobby Lashley a few weeks later. But The Miz did his job, but he still got a WWE title reign out of it. That's fair enough. But he deserves better than this. 2023 has been awful for The Miz. Now, you could say he's not lost every single match he's been in. But he was going to. The match against Shane McMahon at WrestleMania was obviously there for Shane McMahon to come out and get the win. Shane McMahon obviously done his quad in, and Snoop Dogg ended up punching The Miz, did the most weirdest people's elbow you've ever seen, and then pinned The Miz. Now, I think that's a little bit crap for The Miz. He does deserve better. He has been a surefire Hall of Famer in the next 10 years, I would say. Absolutely no doubt about it. He's had some top-level feuds, most notably against Daniel Bryan, the run-ins with John Cena. He's had multiple really top-level feuds. Even the IC title feud against Dolph Ziggler. That was good. That was really, really good. Even though the IC title at that time was a bit like hot potato. Here, you have it. No, you have it. No, okay, I'll have it. But then I want you to have it, kind of thing. And that actually, in that kind of way, did work. Because The Miz and Dolph together as, you know, one-on-one, it's really good. I actually really like their interactions. Especially Dolph as the babyface in that respect. But The Miz, he deserves better than this. He has had two failed babyface runs. That's, you know, it's just is what it is. He's not naturally a babyface. He has gotten over, in a way. You know, when he had the Mr. Raj a few years ago, Bo Dallas and Curtis Axel, that was getting over. He was getting good... everyone at the time was getting reactions against Roman Reigns. He was cheered to high heaven when he beat Reigns to regain the IC title in his eighth reign as champion. And then he went and lost it to Seth Rollins at WrestleMania involved in a triple threat match involving Finn Balor. And yeah, I mean, The Miz just deserves better than this, really. I don't know if he sort of, obviously he would have, is he just accepting what's happened to him at the minute? He's getting on TV, but, you know, whoever he faces, he's just getting pummeled. He lost to someone at night one of WrestleMania as well. Pat McAfee, I think it was. Then he lost against Snoop Dogg, but then was actually meant to lose against Shane McMahon. That's not good. He deserves better than this. He really does. He really deserves better than this. Now, guys, that's my point of view across. I don't know if I can really say much more, but it's just, I just think The Miz deserves better than this. I really do. I really do. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. And there will be another WWE Hot Topic video coming out very soon as well. And that is actually talking about another superstar who's currently winless in 2023. I'm going to leave it there. I'm not going to give too much away. But we're going to be talking about them and why going back to NXT might be a good thing. Thanks for watching. Make sure you leave a like and subscribe if you're new. And I'll see you soon. Cheers.